Hello everyone, welcome back to another tutorial how-to video. Today we're going to be talking about how to make eye-catching YouTube thumbnails. So, you know the saying, you know, don't judge a book by its cover? Unfortunately, everyone judges a YouTube video by its thumbnail. Even if you don't think that you do, if you're scrolling through YouTube, like I am right now, and you search for something like how to make good YouTube thumbnails, you're gonna click on the ones that look the best. Here's my buddy Nick Nimmin here. A great looking thumbnail, very colorful. He's got a great picture of himself here. You know, this one right here, very colorful. If we look at these, all of these have a lot of things in common, right? So we have the whole trick of putting yourself looking extremely shocked in the video, thumbnail, right here, right? Having yourself looking like, oh, you're pointing at the text in the thumbnail. Justin here, another friend of mine, great thumbnail there. We have other thumbnails that are just very colorful. So what I like to do is I do all of my thumbnail design in Photoshop. So if I hop back over to Photoshop here to this thumbnail, because I do tutorial videos, I haven't really gotten into the trend of including an image of myself next to the text. I think that's something that I'm going to A/B test and try. And it's something that depending on your space or your niche in YouTube, maybe you should try. But what I like to do is I go to Photoshop and I open up a new document. I make it 1920 by 1080. Okay, so you change the size there from inches to pixels. So it's 1920 by 1080. So the size is going to be 1080p. Now, one thing that most people don't do when creating their thumbnails, if we hop back over to the thumbnail here, is what I like to do is I like to zoom out about 3 or 4 notches here, and I see what the thumbnail looks like at a much smaller size. And the reason I do that is because the majority, or maybe not the majority, but a large sum of folks are going to be watching or searching for your video on their mobile device. Maybe they have their new iPhone or Android device, whatever it is, and when they're scrolling through the YouTube mobile app, that thumbnail is much smaller, maybe even this size. And if I can't read the text or see what it is and I have to squint my eyes, maybe I need to make a couple of changes in the thumbnail. So try to zoom out at first and then see if there's anything you can do to implement some things that'll make it more mobile friendly, because mobile friendly thumbnails are very, very important. Just look and search for things on your phone or mobile device and see what works. Also, search for the video type that you're doing on YouTube. See what other folks are doing in the space, like I did here, if we hop back over to Google Chrome, and see kind of what other people are doing that have succeeded in the space or targeting the keywords you're trying to target with that specific video. All right, so I have a 1920 by 1080 canvas here. The first thing I like to do is go over here to my rectangle tool, click anywhere on the screen, and then what I like to do is create one that's about 1900, okay, so it's 1920, and then 1060, right? So the width and the height are a little less on each width and height of the canvas here, and I go and I click OK. As you can see here, it's filled the rectangle all the way up. What I want to do is I want to go to the fill over here on the right, and I want to eliminate that by just eliminating the fill, and then I want the stroke to be a little thicker, so I want that to be, say, around, I don't know, 15 there, and then I'll change that nice color to be something very bright like a green. When you're on sites like eBay and Amazon, in order to list your items with a highlight around them, a border around them, you have to pay extra. And so I've always found it to be a really cool thing to do on YouTube to highlight my video with a border around it. So as you see on all of my YouTube thumbnails, I include this nice little rectangle border. That way when folks are searching, as we can go back here, as you can see, a couple of these have done it as well, have the nice little border here. We have a border on some of the ones that Nick does as well. We have a border on this one as well. And so what it does, it just makes your video thumbnail stand out even more by doing something as simple as putting a border around the thumbnail. Now, the next thing is going to be about the text that I have here on my thumbnail. As you can see, the text is rather big, but I've found that if I have the text on top of a colored border, it stands out. Now, I've done A/B testing utilizing TubeBuddy. TubeBuddy is a tool that I use to A/B test thumbnails. So here we are in my YouTube studio on one of my video tutorials here. And then as you can see, I have TubeBuddy installed here where it says TubeBuddy Tools. If I click the drop-down menu there, I can go to A/B test. And if I click on A/B test here, it will allow me to sign in. And as you can see here, it allows me to thumbnail CTR test. So if I select this here, I can have a 14-day trial. So if I select this option here, I want to run it for 14 days. I want to continue. I have one thumbnail here. I can upload another thumbnail right here. So I can upload another thumbnail like this one here, and I can say, okay, I want to test this thumbnail against this one, and I want to see which one performs better. So which one has the higher CTR, which is the click-through rate? Which one is performing better for my channel? That's something that I like to do for my thumbnails. So A/B testing them, trying a couple of them out, is always a very smart thing to do. Now, when it comes to text, you want to make it as large as possible, and you don't want the thumbnail to have so much text that it just overwhelms the image, right? I like to do my tutorial thumbnails to be something very simple, something very similar to my title, and I put the text here, I make it very colorful, I put it on top of colorful borders, and I go with that. I then like to put a nice image background kind of behind my thumbnail here to kind of cover up the white or the blank space on the thumbnail. I like to get all of my imagery from a stock photo website. You can get yours off Google Images for free. Just make sure that you have the rights to use that, you know, you have the creative rights to use that image on your thumbnail. You don't just want to download anything off of a website on Google Images and use it on your thumbnail. I use a site called Envato Elements. It's a little over $100 a year, but I get access to stock music, stock sound effects, stock graphics, stock videos, stock photos. And so anything that I want here, I can go to the drop down, I can go to photos, I can search for, say, dog. And then if I need a dog for one of my thumbnails, I can use any of these images here and not have to worry about copyright strikes. I can click on the image, download that image here, and then put that in my thumbnail. So when it comes to making eye-catching thumbnails, again, think of being mobile friendly. You want it to be very colorful, maybe even add a border to kind of highlight the thumbnail as folks are scrolling down. You may want to experiment with putting a picture of yourself looking shocked or surprised, or just a very high quality image of yourself in the thumbnail to make it more personal. It gives it that more personal touch. And I think that's something that I can improve on my thumbnails, is adding a more personal touch to my thumbnails. And so in closing, I want you to think about those things when creating eye-catching thumbnails. And you don't have to use Photoshop, right? You can use Canva. I've even heard of folks using Google Pixel. You can Pixelator. You can even use different tools or apps on the iOS or Android devices that you like to use. Whatever photo manipulator app you like to use, it will do the same thing that Photoshop does. I just have a subscription to the Adobe Creative Cloud, and so Photoshop is just my go-to, and I've been using it, and so I'm comfortable using it. Let me know in the comment section below, what do you do to make the best and most eye-catching thumbnails possible for YouTube? I would love to know. Don't forget to, you can check out TubeBuddy by using my link down below. You get 30 days for free of trying them out. Also, you can listen to our podcast for free, our YouTube Creators Hub podcast. I interview YouTube creators each and every week, every Friday, for about 30 minutes talking about their journey on the platform. And I will talk to you guys in the next video.